Okay, let's discuss about atomic number. And what is atomic number? Atomic number is the number of proton present in the nucleus of the atom or of an atom. The number of proton present in the nucleus of an atom, that is known as the atomic number. And atomic number is denoted by capital Z. And each element has its own unique atomic number. Each element has its own unique atomic number. No two elements have same atomic number. No two elements have same atomic number. So it determines the property of the element. So it determines the property of the element. And we can also write in short atomic number equal to number of proton. Or we also can define atomic number as number of electron also. We can define atomic number as the number of electron also. Why? Because in a neutral atom, the number of proton and number of electron will always be same. And in short, we can write Z equal to number of proton and number of electron. Here E power minus because it has negative charge, and proton is positive because it has a positive charge. Similarly, atomic mass. Okay, what is atomic mass? And the sum of a number of protons and neutrons present in an atom is called atomic mass of an element. The sum of a number of proton and neutron present in an atom is called atomic mass of an element. Atomic mass and atomic weight means same thing. And it is denoted by the capital A. It is denoted by capital A. And we can also express atomic mass in mathematical form as the given equation. That is atomic mass equal to number of neutron plus number of proton. Atomic mass equal to number of proton plus number of neutrons. And here we neglect the value of electron because the number of electron is so negligible. So we don't include while calculating that atomic mass. It is 1/87,837 part of the that weight of the proton. So it is so less. So we don't include proton while calculating the atomic mass. Okay, let's make the concept more clear through some examples, numerical examples. Look here in this question. First question, there is given the atomic number and atomic weight of a chlorine is 17 and 35 respectively, and we have to calculate the value of or the number of proton and neutron present in that atom of the chlorine. And first of all, we have to write given, and in question there is given the atomic number, that is 17. Atomic weight is given, that is 35, and we have to find out the number of proton, neutron and electron. Proton, neutron and electron. And we know from the definition of atomic number is the number of a proton. So if you have the number of, if you have the atomic number, then we can tell it is also the number of proton or it is also the number of electron. So 17 will be the number of proton and number of electron. Similarly, to find out the number of neutron, we have to use the definition of atomic weight. And from the definition of atomic weight, we have atomic weight means the number of proton plus number of neutron. When there is the sum of a number of proton and number of neutron, we get the value of atomic weight. So to get the value of neutron, we have to subtract the value of proton from the atomic weight. And that is 35 equal to 17 plus neutron here. N is N to the power zero is number of neutron, and number of proton is 17, which you already find in the above calculation. And by solving it, we get the value of the neutron, number of neutron. So the required number of proton, neutrons and electron are 17, 18 and 17. 17, that is the proton and neutron value, proton and electron value, and 18 is the neutron value. 18 is the neutron value. Okay, let's solve another problem. Okay, another problem is atomic number and atomic mass of argon is 18 and 40 respectively. Now we have to calculate the value of proton, neutron, and electron. And we know that atomic mass is given, that is 18, atomic weight is 40, and we have to find out the number of proton, neutron, and electron. And from the definition of atomic number, we have atomic number equal to number of protons. So 18 will be the number of protons, and in a neutral atom there will be same number of proton and same number of electron. And from the definition of atomic weight, we know that atomic weight means the sum of the number of protons and neutron. So we already have the value of proton from the above calculation. So when we substitute that value here, then we get the value of neutron, that is 22. When you subtract 40, and when you subtract 18 from 14, then you got 22. That is the number of neutron. So the number of proton, neutron, and electron present in the argon is 18, 22, and 18 respectively. 18 is proton, 22 is neutron, 18 is electron. Okay, here are some points to remember. Okay, for easy calculation or for direct calculation, we can use this trick. And according to this trick, you have to remember the value of 4. You have to remember the value of the neutron of the 4 atom or element, that is hydrogen, beryllium, and that new nitrogen and argon. The hydrogen neutron value will be 0. It don't have any neutron. Beryllium have 5, and nitrogen has 7, argon has 22. And if you remember this, for other you can use the simple formula, that is, if the proton number is even number, then same number will be of neutron. And if the proton value or proton number is odd, then you have to add 1 on that proton number, and that will be the value of neutron. You have to make one more to the number of proton if the number of the proton is odd. For example, if the proton number is 11, then the value of neutron will be 12. Similarly, if the number of proton is 13, then the number of neutron will be 14. If the value of proton is 17, then the value of neutron will be 18. Okay, I hope you got the concept of that atomic mass, atomic number, and how to calculate the number of neutron of different atom. Okay, thank you.